financing. Okay. So there are different methods of contraception. First is hormonal. Second is barrier method. Then is spermicides and chemical methods. Then comes the long acting reversible methods. Then comes the permanent method. So there are two: permanent method and temporary method. Among temporary, they are short acting and long acting. So before we start, what is this? Condom.
Condom.
So what is the advantage and disadvantage of condom? It has to be used every time. It needs privacy, and the advantage is it is cheap and easily available. Okay. Second disadvantage is it is having high failure rate. Although it can be used, but the method many times may be wrong. So because of the method, or because of the breakage, or because of the slippage, there can be problem. So these causes the high failure rate. So for any contraception, there can be typical user or perfect user. So most of the people will be typical user. So failure rate may be 14 to 15 per 100 women a year. If it is regularly used, then also. What are the non-contraceptive use of condoms?
STDs,
BPH,
prevention of sexually transmitted disease, including HIV. So if the female partner is using any contraception, then also we have to tell the male partner that he has to use, because the infection rate for the recipient will be very high, so that condom will be preventing the sexually transmitted disease. Any other use of condoms?
Tampon.
In case of postpartum hemorrhage, if you are going, then also we have to use this one, as if particularly in atonic PPH. How will you know that it is atonic PPH?
Labiotomy.
Okay. Normal it will be cricket ball. When we are feeling, it will be quite firm. But here it will be flabby uterus. So, but when you are compressing, it is retracting. Then it shows that it is atonic uterus, and because of your measure, there will be prevention of PPH. In that case, what you will do? Any Foley's catheter is there? Yeah. What you will do with this?
Condom.
You wore it, no? From your name?
This is the Foley's catheter. Okay, we'll keep it like this.
No, ma'am, just keep
it. Tie it with the thread. Okay, and then here first we'll put 20 ml to 50 ml so that it doesn't come out, and then we'll instill the saline from here. So this will be ballooned out, and then it will be in the uterine cavity. So this will be like this. Okay. So when you are putting it from here, first same way, just like Foley's catheter, you are putting it here, and then it is getting insulated, and it is in the cervix. I mean, it is not coming out of the cervix. But then you have to put a pressure, intrauterine pressure, so that vessels are not getting opened up, and there is a compression when you are removing it. So what you will do from here? You will instill the normal saline or distilled water from here. So from here, when you are instilling, this will be ballooned. This one. Okay, once it is ballooned out, then there will be compression. So the patient won't be. And after that, you can use other methods. Okay. Next, coming to other method, the use is if we have to do any ultrasound. So this will be the, say, imagine this is the ultrasound probe, and we have to put in the vagina. Yeah. Then also we'll use it, put it inside, and then use it. I will do so that the patient already, she may be suffering from infertility. And when we are putting the probe, there will be infection. So one probe can be used only for one person. So when we are using like this, there will be throwing it off. Goodness. There won't be any infection in the vagina probe. And then this one has to be always told user to cover it up and then throw it, because it won't be immediately degradable. Okay, so it will take long time. Next, coming to other methods of contraception. First is most important we are using is intrauterine contraceptive device. Copper T is there.
So here.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. This is the copper tip. Okay. What you have to do with this?
Insert.
No touch stick. No touch stick.
So you can see this T is there. T is there. I will open and show you. Don't worry. Okay. This is the packet you will be getting. This is normal supply. Okay. What is the advantage of copper T?
Long acting.
Okay. It can be used nowadays, it can be used even in delivery. I mean, who has not delivered, then also we can use this. Earlier we were not using until she is having one or two children. Okay, so now it is the most common method which Government of India is promoting and we are using it. Okay, the advantages are it is reversible. It is cost effective. It is one time use. You have to insert for the lady once and it will be effective for 10 years. Okay, there will be other one, they will be effective at least for 5 years. So in case any time she wants to remove, that time she can get it removed also. And it is user friendly because again and again she need not come for checkup. Once she has got a checkup done after 1 month and there is no complication, so every 6 months she can come for checkup. That's all. It is not that every day like OC pills she has to take every day. Okay, so these are the advantages. What are the disadvantages? Infection. So what are the contraindications? There will be some problem why we are will not be using inserted five piece.
Pregnancy.
Okay, any patient if you cannot rule out pregnancy, you are not going to put this device. So pregnancy is the first. Second, PID. Any active infection. Not the previous history of infection is there. But if any active infection is there, we should not keep intrauterine contraceptive device because once we are putting instilling it, it will go inside the cavity, the infection. Third thing,
prolapse.
That is side effect.
Prolapse
also not most of them will happen. Before that, please.
Suspect. Unexplained vaginal bleeding.
Yeah. Per vaginal bleeding. Okay. Per vaginal bleeding. Any bleeding per vaginal undiagnosed, unexplained, we should not use. Maybe it is CA service, maybe it is just infection or vaginitis, but what happens, the patient may blame that this bleeding is because of it. Yeah. Okay, and sometimes heavy bleeding already the patient is having, and if it goes, it is not going to sort out her problem. Okay, so any undiagnosed bleeding, we should use this or not?
No.
So what we should use if it is undiagnosed bleeding? We should diagnose it. Okay. And then we may use oral contraceptive pills. First we should know what is the cause of bleeding. Then we have to use. Okay. So first be pregnancy. Second PID. Third is
undiagnosed
per vaginal bleeding. Then any other P? Puerperal sepsis.
Puerperal
sepsis is there. Immediately after delivery she was having lot of infection. High fever is there. Uterus is not, this thing, it is still not involuted properly, and then she is coming after 1 month for, and false urine discharge is there. Will you keep this? No. Post-septic abortion, then also better not to put. If big pelvic mass is there, okay, any big fibroid is there, any other pelvic mass is there, then also better to avoid this one. So all these you will remember, then one is congenital malformation. Okay, other many same things are there, active heart disease is there, diabetes is, if infection with diabetes is there, in those cases we should not put. But these fees you should not forget. Clear? How you will put? First we use, we may need help of somebody to hold this. First we should do is medical history taking and examination of the patient. So what all history taking will ask? Last period. Okay. She had 3 days back. Will you put or not? Yes. If it is 10th day, yes. Will you put?
Yes.
11th day?
Yes.
She had intercourse on 10th and 11th day she is coming. Will you put? Yes. Yes. Why?
Works
as emergency contraceptive for 5 days also. So that way also you can put. Mostly when emergency contraceptive contraception is there, we only remember some pills are there which we will prescribe. Okay. So this is also effective and it can be used for long term. She has unplanned sex and she has come to you and now she wants long term prevention also. So you can prevent also and treat also at the same time. So this can be used for both the purposes. So you have to take history of her periods, when she has delivered, if what are the methods she can give immediately after delivery, it is post-transcendental insertion within 10 minutes. Then it is interval, after 6 weeks she is coming, at least after 1 week then she is coming, then also you can put, but it will be interval. Then it is during cesarean section, then also you can insert plus, as soon as placenta is removed. You see that any malformation is not there, uterus is fine, then you can put it. What is it? It is called postpartum intrauterine contraceptive device insertion. How we are going to do is later we will explain it. Then comes, when we are taking the history, we should ask any history of wide discharge or any infection was there, was it treated or not. And then we are coming for examination. When we are examining, we have to see that pelvic examination we are doing, any infection is there, we should tell her not to, and if there is any excessive history of bleeding, then also we should avoid it, all those things after that, then we will put it, clean the area, put in a comfortable position, lithotomy may be ideal, but at least with lying down, with legs flexed also is fine, then you are using, one helper should be there, and some attendant should be there, sometimes may rarely vasovagal shock can be happening. Okay, so we should have that. Then after that what we'll do? We'll put the instrument here after asking her to empty the bladder. Okay, any vaginal work if you are doing, you should see that patient is having empty bladder. Then you are putting and asking the your assistant to hold it. After that, you'll see the cervical lip. Okay, so this, imagine this is the cervix. Okay, so what you'll do? This is anterior, this is the posterior. You will hold anterior or posterior?
Anterior.
Okay. So what you will do after holding? Little you will hold and again you should see with uterine sound, confirm the uterine size and length. Okay. So where is the sound?
No.
Yeah. So after that you will see how it is and here markings are there. So again what you will do? This is the, so we are seeing this, it is there, so we are putting it like this. Okay, the marker will be here. Okay, so if you feel the size is bigger, so then we have to change. You can see that. Okay, now once you are putting inside, see, I
this blue marker according to the length of the fetal cervical length, you can adjust this
here.
Don't touch the property inside. The sound will be placed over it and measure the length and put this part according to that.
Yes, it is there. Okay. So what should we do? We should push it or withdraw it?
Withdraw.
So how you'll withdraw? This is there enough? This has to come back. Can you do it? Pushing down. Yes, or up. Okay, if we are pushing it up, we will be putting in more chances of perforation. Again, what you show, that in this figure, people have not seen. No, you touch. We should not touch, but because we have to show we are touching. Otherwise, inside only, we have to put these
all
two arms. Can you see these two arms, all of you? These are the two arms. This is copper T inserted. Advantages, first is, it will be working as a leukocyte and it will be against the sperms itself. Second is, when it is missed, okay, then also we can do an x-ray and find out. Okay, so that is second advantage of copper T. First is for prevention of pregnancy, as contraception. Second is, it is easier for us to find out the lost copper T. You can see, there are two arms and because it is like a T, it is called copper T. Okay. Now she will put these two arms inside. Once the two arms are kept inside, we have to put it according to our measurement what we have taken inside the uterine cavity. If it is going up, little slightly up. Or if it is deeply retroverted, then also we have to see how it is. But mostly it will go easily, there won't be any difficult. Only sometimes in nulliparous lady, there may be a problem. Although normal, a lady who has delivered, they won't be, or she had an abortion, then it is easily going. Okay. Then how it will be going? She has checked her measurement. This is the length of the uterine cavity. And then now she will be doing withdrawal technique.
I have adjusted the length here. So with no touch technique, don't touch the vagina, perineum, any walls. Then you inserted this into the uterine cavity. Keeping this hand steady, like this. So, I inserted this.
Okay, this one will be working for 10 years. There may be others also which will be working for 3 years and 5 years. Okay, but what is the advantage? That it can be used for long term. But disadvantage is it is more effective if the patient is having monogamous relationship, not having any active sexual disease, or her partner is not having any infection, she is not having active bleeding, or very menstrual irregularity. In those cases, it works. If those problems are there, if she is having excessive bleeding before copper T insertion, then we should not put this. If she is having mild spotting or some bleeding on and off in the first 2 months of her insertion, then we can give her tranexamic acid or mefenamic acid or combination of both, and we can reduce the spotting or bleeding what is happening and reassure her that mostly after 2 to 3 cycles her periods will be fine and bleeding won't be happening. The biggest disadvantage with this, lot of misconception it is there, that will it prick me, will everybody know about it, all those questions you have to reassure the patient that it won't be causing anything, it won't go inside on its own. Many times they will have misconception, so those things we have to rule out. Second is coming to, if she is still having bleeding but she wants intermittent contraceptive device, then what you do? I think we cannot
open it.
They are not
having.
Okay.
It's empty.
So this is the other one. If she is bleeding, if she is having excessive bleeding, okay, and still she wants long-term reversible method. She says, see, my husband is not using condom. The patient will be typical like that. And she will be telling me which one we have to use now. So then you have to use this one. So you have diagnosed it is only excessive bleeding during periods. She has told that there is no other problem and you have ruled out any pathology. Then this one will be working better for that patient rather than your normal intrauterine contraceptive device. And this one is given by Government of India. So it is not that you will be charging any extra money for it. So you have to reassure her, it will be having levonorgestrel 50 mg and it will be releasing 20 mg per day. Okay, so this can be quite effective. What are the disadvantages of it? Sometimes it will cause amenorrhea. So you have to tell the patient that it may cause amenorrhea. Second?
Thromboembolic phenomenon.
Thromboembolism with progesterone, really, this thing is less. Ocipins is less. Spotting, on and off spotting she is there. Every time she starting. And sometimes, because pseudo pregnancy like breastfeminus and all, really it will happen. Although the hormone level will be less and it will be going in the uterine cavity only. Okay, but spotting and amenorrhea are common symptoms with these patients. Clear? So, intrauterine contraceptive device, these two will be there. Then coming to oral contraceptive pills. Anything you have?
Yeah.
Okay. So, what they contain? Why they are called low dose? Ethinyl estradiol. But read that and speak it. That is the biggest thing. Okay. Many times your brain may not work, although you might be remembering all the topics, but that time it won't work. So that time you see that everything is written in this. Okay. You may not be given that much chance to open and read, but this much is written. Okay. So in case you are not able to answer, then also you should be able to answer what it contains. And remember that all low dose contraceptive pill will be having 30, 35, 50 and all you should not tell in exam. Okay, clear? How the patient should be used?
From 25th day to 21st day.
Okay, she is taking every day. And if she is missing Monday, what do you tell?
She has to take whenever she remembers.
And the next tablet at usual time. If she is taking post dinner every day, let her take that. If she is missing 2 days,
she has to take another contraception
for how many days?
One week at least.
1 week. And depends upon what cycle it is. If she can take full cycle, it is good. But at least 1 week she has to use, and depending upon the what we say, first 1 week if she has taken, then it is fine. 1 week is enough. If she has taken at the time of ovulation, it has to be continued. And then gap has to be left out. The gap should not be there. Okay, clear? What are the indications and contraindications? First is, she should know that what she is taking, she has to be counseled properly. She should be willing. Okay, next, she should not have any active grade 4 heart disease or uncontrolled diabetes, uncontrolled hypertension, history of family, history of thromboembolism. In those cases, we should not give. Here only we can give intrauterine contraceptive device. Because if the patient is having history of heart disease, we can use intrauterine contraceptive device, but it should be no touch technique. Okay, we should not touch anything and then use. But ideal will be that variable contraception for husband or vasectomy will be best. Still she wants, then we can use IUCD, but we cannot use OSIC pill on the cases where we are having lot of medical contraindication. What are the side effects?
Hepatic adenoma
is less than 1%. So when an exam is coming, those things we should tell in the last. Okay? Nausea, vomiting, increase in weight gain, only 1 to 2. Okay, it should not be too much of weight gain. Most of the patients may complain that all weight gain is because of the pill, but they will be having more dinner. Okay. That is not a thing. They are only 1 to 2 kgs, that too because of the progesterone, water retention will be there, and feeling of well-being can be there. So these two things can cause weight gain. But you have to reassure that it is only 1 to 2 kgs. What are the other side effects?
Withdrawal bleeding
can be there.
Breakthrough bleeding is more.
Okay, so you should remember breakthrough bleeding. How effective it is? Failure rate is good or bad?
Good.
1 to 3, it is equal as much to permanent method.
Okay. I see. Permanent.
What are the contraindications? Any bleeding which we have not diagnosed, in those cases we should not give. And the patient where she cannot take regularly, the most important thing is regularly she has to use. Failure rate will be less if she is taking regular. But she, if she is called up, she is not, she is missing, then she should not be used. Then, what are the non-contraceptive uses of these tablets?
Heavy menstrual bleeding,
menorrhagia.
Endometriosis, Mittelschmerz, premenstrual
syndrome. Why we should use in those cases? PID doesn't help much.
Endometriosis, ciprofloxacin acetate.
Endometriosis, yes, but not very ideal for that. Only thing, if the patient is having too much of pain, then we can use.
DOP, prevents malignancy.
PCOD, yes. PCOD. Why? Because PCOD patients will be having irregular periods and it will be regularizing. In those cases, we can use. What is the non-contraceptive use of this?
Menorrhagia.
Adenomyosis. 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 Hypoplasia is there, then also you can use. You have diagnosis that this is the reason, then also you can use. If the patient is on HRT, then also you can use progesterone like this, intrauterine and only estrogen level. So these things we can use. If she is having adenomyosis, in those cases also you can use this one. Okay. Frequent side effect with OCPs can be nausea, vomiting, headache. Okay, if the patient is having history of migraine, then better to avoid it. Then category 1, 2, 3, 4 you will be having and more. But in this practical thing, at least this much you should remember. Okay. Then this one. Before Provera we don't have injection now, but many times it may be supplied by the government. Okay, so the injection will be like this, loaded one. I will show you. It will be like this. So this will be there. So what is the advantage of injection depot provera? It is used, only female has to be coming to the hospital and every 3 months she has to take. So even if male is not cooperative, then also she can come and take the injection. Okay, but drawback is young patients who are very thin built. For them, long term if she is using, there will be bone mass density can be reduced with this. Osteoporosis, osteopenia, chances will be more. So in those cases, we should avoid depot provera injection. Then other contraindications are, she may have amenorrhea. So we have to counsel the patient earlier that there may be every 3 months amenorrhea, so she should not get worried. And sometimes breakthrough bleeding can happen with this also. Then is weight gain again, 22 kg weight gain can be there with depot provera. And every 3 months she has to come to the hospital and the injection should be given. Not that she has to take at home anywhere, any nurse can give. So we have to be very particular about giving it. Advantage is, again, it is long acting and reversible. Every 3 months, if she is taking at least 3 months, she won't be conceiving. And any other hormones is the contraceptive patch that we won't be giving in injection exam. So contraceptive patch will be coming in short notes and in a written exam, but it may not come in practical. So you should know about depot provera, may be there, may not be there. But intrauterine contraceptive, definitely it will be there. Oral contraceptive pills will be there. Then emergency contraceptive pill that we are not having emergency pill, no? That will be there. Now we are not having, it will be just like this. There will be 2 tablets, 0.75 mg. She can have at 12 hours gap. Okay, only 2 tablets should be taken within 72 hours of the urge protector intercourse. It can be slippage, breakage, or she didn't plan or whatever, but she has to take the 2 tablets. And this, and in case she is not having and she is coming to you, you can use intrauterine contraceptive device also. So both the things are emergency contraceptive. UHP regime you should know for short notes. It won't be coming before this thing. And because it is having high dose of estrogen and all, it causes lot of nausea, vomiting. Thromboembolism chances with emergency contraceptive is quite less, but sometimes the patient every cycle if she is taking frequently, then the chances of thromboembolism will be high, as equal to more than OCPs. Okay, so if the patient is not taking OCPs in the fear of thromboembolism, and if she is taking emergency contraceptive, you should tell her that low dose is better than taking frequently high dose. What are the, any Bangkok is there here?
Yes, ma'am.
Babcock.
Babcock.
Imagine this is the tube. Fallopian tube. Okay. What are the methods?
Pomeroy's, Ichidas.
Shirodkas, Uchidas,
Madlener.
Anything you know?
Uchidas.
All Ichidas.
So what will do? You read only for theory exam. For practical, only one next. One method.
Pomeroy.
Here?
Yes.
One. So how you'll use? This is the tube. What are the parts of tube?
Intramural, isthmus,
ampullary,
fimbriole.
What we should do? Where we should put? Intramural isthmus. And there is a lock, so you can have the good grip. Okay, it won't be slipping enough. So I have holding, and now she is just like this. She will do. Okay, so there also in OT also will be doing like this. Clear? Okay. So after that we should not crush it. The tube should not be crushed. See, what is just put it. If we are crushing like this, what happens? More chances of ectopic pregnancies will be there. So we should not crush them. What we do, because we think that there will be bleeding, she should not go for recanalization, we crush it, and then we electrocautery, we burn that tissue. These things are not needed. Okay? So just she will hold it, and then what you should do? Now with what?
Chromic acid.
What we'll do? How we'll do? From here we'll take. And then tie it. Okay, first year, second year. And then the second one, surrounding one more. And then you have to just cut it. This part will be cut. So you can see here. Okay. A wing turn movement. Okay. This side you are able to see? That tube you have seen? All of you? Cutting. It is not going to help you the method is not going to save you, and at the same time it becomes difficult. It is only difficult in certain cases where lot of additions are there. Then only we will go for all other methods, whatever you have named it. Rarely we will be using those methods. So when you are telling in exam, you should use modified Pomeroy's technique. Okay, clear? So that is the only thing we are using. So this you can see Babcock. Anybody who is having any doubt about this instrument should see again.
Laparoscopic.
What if I earlier what we were doing is very normal. Now we are normal. What I have explained is modified. So what are the drawbacks? It is irreversible. Okay. Both the consent should be there. It is not that husband has undergone already and then wife also is coming and then they want some money and then they will come for, because government of India will be giving money for all those things. Okay. So it should be only one person has to go. Not both have to go. Okay. And if she is going, it should be that she is having at least one child. Many times what happens, they will say that no, I am not planning, I don't want. Then you should not go for any permanent method. At least one child and that too 1 year. Okay, then only you will go. In fact, if any doubt, if it is there, say the first child is having congenital heart disease or any health problem or the developmental milestones are delayed, in those cases you will go for long-acting reversible method, but you won't go for permanent method. What are the drawbacks? It can have anesthetic complications. Okay, second is bowel or bladder injury. When we are planning to pull the tube, we can pull some other things also. Bowel, bladder, if we are not careful. We can just ligate round ligament and think that we have ligated tube. So those cases cause more failure rather than again reattaching of the tubes. Okay. And infection.
We
are sent for ideally we should send, but many times if we are sure, we need not send. Then infection, particularly if you are going for camps and all, we have to be extra careful that no infections are there, because many patients at a time we are doing. So infection, sepsis, all these things will be there. Second is, we have to rule out if the patient is already pregnant. So first is, you should rule out pregnancy. Otherwise, she will claim that although this method was used by doctor, but it has failed. So rule out pregnancy first. Second is, it can be done both the way. It can be done in interval sterilization also and immediately after delivery also. When we are doing immediately after delivery, 1 to 2 cm subumbilical. We have to palpate the fundus and then we have to go just at the level of tubes and then give a nick of 1.5 to 2 cm and catch the tubes and do it. When internal sterilization is there, the uterus is already pelvic organ. Then we have to do supra-pubic incision and lift the tube and then do it. The method is same, but the level of incision will be different in both. Now the patient wants laparoscopy. Then what do you look?
Fallopian.
For all patients, you know, first you have to rule out any medical disorders. Because then again we are doing a general analysis. This time mostly we have done a spinal analysis. There, short G at least will be given. These are the instruments. What is this? Wing applicator. Can you see? All of you? This white one is ring. There is the tube. So what we will do first, very and broken are there? Already discussed, no? So you have given the pneumoperitoneum like this, then you have put the trocar inside. After that, you are putting this instrument through the same trocar. Okay? Okay, it's okay. Just imagine this is a little bigger one, so we will put like this. This is the trocar and we are putting like this. Is there? This one is there. Okay, so in this, we will remove this. This is only to insert, because without this one, no one going there. So once we are putting this, it will go. Once it is gone, we will remove it. Like this, it will be in the abdomen. So this is the abdomen of the patient. Okay, now you are putting inside. Then, this is the tube. like this. And then this tube is bigger, so it is not going to go, the ring is not going. Otherwise, this ring will go inside. This fallopian ring will go inside. I mean, it will be surrounding it. It will be surrounding it. It will be here in the uterine cavity, I mean, in the abdominal cavity, and it won't be there. 5 minutes. Like this it will be.
Yes.
Okay. So it will be coming out. Here it won't be there. It will be coming on the surrounding the tube. Okay. Here. Back. So this is coming out and sliding inside here. And then your instrument will be coming out. So the ring is here. You can see. The ring is here. Okay. Here, the ring will be here. This instrument you can take out. So this is surrounding the fallopian tube. Okay. What are the indications? Kanna indications? Immediately after delivery, should we do laparoscopy?
No. We don't give general advice.
Immediately after delivery, should we do double punch laparoscopy and fallopian ring application or not? No, because the uterus will be big organ. It will be up to umbilicus. So it's better to avoid it. Okay, there will be cardiovascular changes also. So it should be done later. Okay, if the patient is immediately coming, then postnatal tubectomy is with mini laparotomy is better method. Okay, this one we'll be doing at least after 6 weeks is ideal. It can be done in midwife, but ideal is after 6 weeks. Once it has become a pelvic orbit, then we can use, and any medical contraindication should be ruled out. Then again, the patient age should be above 22, she should be mentally stable, there should be no medical disorder, and she should be fit, she should not be grossly anemic. In those cases, we should not do laparoscopic method. Then, coming to PPICD. This is what?
Yeah.
I can't remove it, but why this instrument has been given, not Valsalam? Valsalam normally
cervix is
soft cervix. So if you are using that, it will be, the tissues also will come out. So the ideal will be sponge holder you have to use. Then again speculum. Then with the calyx forceps putting the property inside, we have to go inside the uterine cavity and open it, and then the thread should be seen or not?
Yes, it should be seen.
Where? Yeah, outside the vagina. Then what happens? Later, extra thread we have to cut or not?
Yes.
Sometimes if it is too long, then we have to cut. But most of the time, uterus will be large, so we may not be needing also. Then what you will do, consent should be taken before antenatal period itself or before delivery, not after delivery. Okay, that time she may not be in a condition to give you consent or not. Counseling should be done. If any, in what cases we should avoid PPIUCD? PRM. If more than 4 hours, if she is having bleeding, we should avoid, because infection rate will be high. Congenital malformation of uterus, we suspected a cesarean section. Those cases also you should not give. Then PPH. Then we should not put IUCD. Although it may not increase the bleeding, but sometimes it may, the patient may think that this has caused the bleeding. Most of the time it may not aggravate the bleeding. But still, because we may have to use other method, condom, catheter and all, PPIUCD should not be kept. Once the bleeding has stopped, then we can use it again. Within 72 hours, later also you can use it. Then any placenta previa is there. The bed will be not good. So most cases we should avoid using postpartum intrauterine contraceptive device. So in those cases we should not use. Then coming to non for male contraception, anything else is there?
Non-scalpel vasectomy.
Is it audible, no? one time it is cost effective. If a male and female both are coming to you and both are they want permanent method, whom you will choose? Male or female?
Male.
Because it is easier to do. Okay. And what are precautions you will tell the patient? That he has to use T-shaped bandage, he should not do overexertion for next 3 weeks. And in those cases, again, after surgery, later you have to repeat the semen analysis, that it is clear or not. Why? Because in those cases, if failure rate is there, again, litigation chances are there for you. So in those cases, it is always better to do semen analysis and see there is no sperm in that post-operative analysis what you have got in the later period. Advantage is the no scalpel, because we are not using the scalpel. What we will do is, again, the scrotum will be there, this is vas, will feel it. And then once we are feeling it, there only with the blade, we are taking a curved artery and then spreading the incision, this thing. Just small nick will be there, and then we'll pull the vas deferens and then do the cutting and ligation. So it is very easy and it can be done, and immediately after 2 to 3 hours the patient can be discharged also. Patient should be advised not to do heavy work for a few days, that's all. Okay. And in these cases, local anesthesia you can do. You need not take general anesthesia or spinal anesthesia. Only thing that it is irreversible. So the counseling should be there for both male and female partner that it is irreversible. It won't protect the patient from sexually transmitted disease. That should be told to the patient. Okay. Any other doubt about it? Contraceptive methods? Medical termination you have discussed or not?
No.
What? Discussion is over?
Yes,
ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
Yes,
yes, yes.
First trimester medical termination, how will you look?
Emergency. Thank you.